blast that the saucer had given him. It was such an incredible thing. It was just unbelievable. I was in an instant panic. The guys behind me, somebody says, get the hell out of here. So I hit the gas, and we took off down the road.
Mike Rogers and the other five witnesses returned only to find Travis missing. After they told their astounding story to the police, they came under suspicion of murder. An intense search for Travis Walton proceeded for 3 days using a large posse, dogs, and helicopters. They were unable to find him or any signs of where he was. Finally, it was suggested that the six witnesses take a polygraph test to establish the truth or fallacy of their story.
We told them, you know, we'll take polygraph tests, we'll take sodium pentothal, hypnosis, anything you can give us, because this thing really happened, and we don't like this thing about you accusing us of murder, which several of them had openly.
Arrangements were made for Cy Gilson, a highly qualified polygraph examiner who was a member of the Arizona State Polygraph Association, to conduct the polygraphs on the six witnesses to Travis Walton's UFO encounter. The utmost care in administering these lie detector tests was exercised because the men were under suspicion of murder.
Once the tests got underway, he started changing his mind very quickly. After he'd tested about three of the six, he seemed to be acting differently. By the time he had tested all of us, he seemed to be a believer. I talked to him after the tests, and he indicated to me that apparently he was wrong. Unofficially, he said that he believed that we had told the truth, because five of us passed the test. He wrote in his report that we had told the truth, that apparently there had been a UFO. This was a very emotional thing for Travis's family and emotional for us. Travis was my best friend, and our whole lives have been disrupted by this. We wondered if we would ever see him again.
When I regained consciousness, I was laying on my back. I came to slowly. I was in a lot of pain in my head and chest area. At first, I thought I was in a hospital. But when I could finally see, I saw these beings standing over me, and I just became hysterical. They were about 5 feet tall. They had no hair, no eyelashes, eyebrows, but very large heads, very large eyes. The rest of their features, nose, mouth, and ears were small, and they were very white looking. I knocked them away from me, and jumped off of the table there, and they started to come toward me. And I grabbed an object off of the bench there and threatened them.
Docking request granted. Landing gear deployed. Successful. Engines disengaged. Thank you.